Welcome to the Vector Garden. So, there's been an update to Affinity Designer which introduced a new tool. Let's take a look at it. It's the flood fill tool, and you find it here, that paint bucket icon. So let's see what it can do for us. I've got an artwork here, which is just open paths crossing each other. And you probably know that when you select them all and then apply a fill, this happens. This is not what you want most of the time. So the flood fill tool can solve that. Now let's take the tool and let's just select a color. And you see when you roll over, the areas that can be filled get highlighted. So you click here, the color gets filled into it, and then you have this area filled. So let's take the direct selection tool and let's assume we want to adjust that path. And you see when we do that, the fill doesn't get adjusted because Affinity Designer immediately builds shapes once you fill the color into that mess. So let's select it again and see what else we can do. So when you take that tool again and let's select a different color, you see you can not only just click, but you can also click and drag and fill multiple in a row. And when you've done that, then you've also created these shapes. And you see this one didn't get connected, but these are all connected. All of these that I've created in a row get connected immediately. So this is nice. Let's delete this one. And those paths, they just stay as they were before using the tool. Now, what else can we do? I'm going to delete this, and let's select it again and take the tool. You can also use it to fill pixel images into it. So let's go here, and I've created a pattern here, which is a PNG. Let's see that we can focus it and just drag it over there, over the fill. And you see it gets highlighted, and we can just click and drag, and this gets filled into it. Let's see what it does by dragging in another one. Let's see that we can focus it, and there it is, you see. And when you then fill that in, you see you get all these parts filled in, because this is now used as a pattern. So when I'm creating a very large rectangle over here and using it, you see, this is what it does. So it's really using this as a pattern. It is not creating a clipping mask. So the image gets filled into the shape directly. Let's take a look at another thing. So I've got these few lines here, and let's take the tool and roll over it. And you see, it doesn't highlight. So something is wrong here. Let's just zoom into this. And I know where I've made the mistake. So let's zoom into it. And you see, this is not closed. So when the areas aren't closed, then the tool doesn't recognize them. It doesn't have that tolerance, so you cannot adjust that. There are some options up here, but you cannot set up a tolerance, which makes it a little difficult to use when you want to edit like CAD files. They often contain some slight intolerances that prevent you from filling areas. Let's take a look at another thing you can do with the tool. So let's take a look at the assets. And I have some circles here, so like so, and let's just add them to the assets. And these are vector paths. You see, these are ellipses that I've created using the ellipse tool. Let's just add them all here. And when I'm going to add them back again. Then you see it's an ellipse, so it stays a vector path. Now let's just draw a shape here and use the fill tool. And let's first just apply a fill. And then you can also select one of these things and fill it in here. And you see the yellow is below it. And let's take the blue one and let's take this green one and the other blue one. And you see they get stacked somehow. So what happens here? First thing is we're going to move into this really close. And you see these are not vector shapes anymore. So Affinity Designer still, when it fills artwork into other objects as a pattern fill, then it makes them, it converts them into pixel images. So even if these are vector shapes and stay vector shapes, once you fill them into an object, they are converted to pixels. And let's take a look at the appearance panel here and select this thing. And you see when filling these, all these things you fill into it get stacked in the appearance panel. And so when you fill a shape with another pattern or fill, then you have to just check this out in order to maybe delete what you don't need so that the file doesn't get too large and so that you don't get these kind of weird fills that you might not have wanted. So that's it for our look at the update and particularly this new tool it offers.